Hello students, today we are going to discuss some important previous questions. Now, the first question: for a first order reaction, A gives 2B plus C at a constant volume and 300 Kelvin temperature. The total pressure at the beginning, that is the T0, and at the time interval T are P0 and PT respectively. Initially, only reactant A is present with the concentration A0. And T1/3 is the time required for the partial pressure of A to reach 1/3 of its initial value. The correct options are: assume all the gases behaves as a ideal nature. Okay, so this is the IIT Advanced 2018 paper. Okay, now the first one, I am writing the equation. What is the equation given here? A gives 2B plus C. A gives 2B plus C. Now all these are gaseous substances. Okay. Now when T0, that is the initial condition, the P0 is the initial partial pressure of a reactant A only. The partial pressure of B and C will be 0 because initially only reactants are present in the container. At a certain time interval T, let's suppose from the P0 pressure of A, let P pressure will decompose into products B and C, according to which 2P pressure of B and P pressure of C, that is the partial pressure of B and partial pressure of C, will be formed. Okay. Now one more information given: the time T1/3, that is the 1/3 of a reaction get completed. So from the P0, 1/3 of the P0, that will be the P0/3 decomposes, according to which 2P0/3 and P0/3 partial pressure of B and C will be formed, because the stoichiometry will be 2:1 in the products. Now what is the total pressure? What is the total pressure at a time interval T? P0 minus P plus 2P plus P. So total pressure at a time interval T, 2P plus P0 or P0 plus 2P. From here, this is the PT, that is the total pressure. Now I want to find the P, which is equal to P total minus P initial divided by 2. Okay. Now here I want to find the K, that is the rate constant for the first order kinetics. K is equal to 1/T ln P0 initial partial pressure of a reactant divided by P0 minus P, that is the partial pressure of a reactant at a time interval T. Here 1/T ln P0 will be the initial partial pressure of a reactant divided by P0 minus P, partial pressure of a what is the P value here? P total minus P0 upon 2. Are you getting my point? After complete simplification of this one, you will get the K value, that is equal to 1/T ln 2P0 whole divided by 3P0 minus PT, that is the total pressure at time interval T. Okay. Now if you expand this, you will get ln 3P0 minus P total will be equal to minus K times of time plus ln 2P0. If you see this expression, it is in the form of y is equal to minus mx plus c. That means if you draw a graph by taking the ln 3P0 minus PT on the y-axis and time interval on the x-axis, then you will get a straight line with a negative slope. If you see first option, ln 3P0 minus PT on the y-axis and time interval on the x-axis, so the graph is correct. That is the option A is the correct option. Okay. Remember, this is more than one correct option. Okay. Now, if the first option A is correct, then the third option C will be incorrect, because in the third option on the y-axis, ln P0 minus PT, that is not possible. Now come to two options, B and D options. Okay, option A is correct and option C incorrect. Okay, now come to the time taken for the 1/3 of reaction get completed, that is the T 1/3. Okay, now I am calculating K is equal to 1 by 3, that is K is equal to 1 by time taken for the 1/3 of reaction get completed, T 1/3. Okay, ln initial concentration, that is the partial pressure of reactant, P naught. Okay, divided by P naught minus P, how much completed, 1/3 of the reactant get consumed, that is P minus P naught minus P naught by 3. So from here K is equal to 1 by time taken for 1/3 of reaction get completed, ln this will be equal to 3P naught upon 2P naught. So P naught, that is the initial partial pressure, gets cancelled here. So finally you will get the T 1/3 will be equal to ln 3/2 whole divided by K. If you know in the first order, the time period for the completion of any fraction of reaction will be independent on the initial concentration. Yes or no? That means here if you draw a graph between T 1/3 versus initial concentration of a reactant, then you will get a which line? Straight line parallel to the concentration axis. Yes or no? Now in the option B, T 1/3, this is what? T 1/3, time taken for the 1/3 1/3 of reaction get completed, there is a straight line with a negative slope. That means option B will be incorrect. Option B will be incorrect. Now come to option D, the rate constant. Now what is the rate constant here? K. The rate constant, if you see, rate constant K is independent on the initial concentration of any order of the reaction. Remember, irrespective of the order of the reaction, the rate constant K value is always independent on the initial concentration. Are you getting my point? That means if you want to draw a graph between K, that is a rate constant, versus initial concentration of a reactant, then always you will get a straight line that is parallel to the x-axis. Because K is a rate constant, the rate constant value depend only temperature and the catalyst and activation energy and some other, that is the stoichiometry of the reaction. In general, the K value especially constant at a constant temperature. Now if you see the option number D, the rate constant, that is constant, that will be parallel to the concentration axis, that is the initial concentration, that is the x-axis, that means option D is also correct. So here there are two options are correct, that means option A and option D both are correct. Option A and option D both are correct. Are you getting my point? So this is a previous IIT advanced level question. Okay, now come to question number 65. It is also previous IIT advanced question. In the reaction, P plus Q gives R plus S. The time taken for the 75% of a reaction of P will is twice the time taken for the 50% of reaction of the P. And the concentration of Q varies with the reaction time as shown in the figure. So in the question, there are two information given regarding the order with respect to P and order with respect to Q. Are you getting my point? That means, first of all, with respect to P, what is the given information? Time required for 75% of completion will be P, will be twice the double of the 50% of the completion of the reaction. With respect to P, T 75%, that is the time taken for the completion of 75%, will be equal to double the time taken for the 50% completion of the reaction. If you see in the previous lecture, I explained the characteristics of a first order kinetics. If you see, time required for the 75% completion of a first order kinetics will be equal to 2 times of the half life. That means this is corresponding to which order reaction? First order kinetics. This is corresponding to which order reaction? First order kinetics. Are you getting my point? That means order with respect to P, accelerate first order kinetics. Okay. Now order with respect to P is the first order. Now come to second one. The concentration of a Q varies with time as shown in the figure. Now if you see in zero order reaction, in which order reaction? In zero order kinetics. In zero order reaction, the concentration of reactant at a particular time of interval AT will be equal to minus KT plus concentration of reactant at initial time interval, that is the T is equal to 0. Do you know this is in the form of Y is equal to minus MX plus C. Now if you plot the graph, you will get a straight line with a negative slope. Are you getting my point? Straight line with negative slope. Now here the question is with respect to Q, that means the concentration of Q at any time interval on the y-axis and time taken on the x-axis, you will get a straight line with negative slope. Okay, so this is the initial concentration of reactant with respect to Q, that is the Q0. So this graph is corresponding to which order kinetics? Zero order kinetics. Therefore order with respect to Q, zero order. Order with respect to Q, zero. Order with respect to Q, zero. Order with respect to P, first order. So total order, overall order is the question. So 1 plus 0, that is the 1, that is the first order kinetics. Are you getting my point? That is the option number D. So if you want to write the rate law expression, that is K into concentration of P with respect to P, order will be 1, and concentration of a Q, order with respect to Q will be 0. So overall K times of the concentration of P only. So what is the overall order of the reaction here? Order with respect to P, first order, plus order with respect to Q, zero order. So overall it is a first order kinetics. Overall it is a first order kinetics. Okay. Now come to the question number 66. Decomposition of a hydrogen peroxide, that is called H2O2, follows first order kinetics. In 15 minutes, that concentration of H2O2 decreases from 0.5 molar to 0.125 molar. And in when the concentration of H2O2 reaches to 0.05 molar, then what is the rate of formation of oxygen? Rate of formation of oxygen. First of all, what is the thermal decomposition of hydrogen peroxide? What is the thermal decomposition of hydrogen peroxide? H2O2 gives what? H2O plus O2. Are you getting my point? H2O2 gives what? H2O plus O2. If you want to balance the equation, then you can balance this. Otherwise, you can multiply with 2 on both sides also. Okay. Now here, first of all, it is a first order kinetics. It is which order kinetics? First order kinetics. In the question, it is mentioned this is a first order kinetics. Now what is the concentration of a reactant initially given? That is nothing but 0.5 molar. Now if the concentration of reactant become 0.125 molar. Okay, 0.125 molar in 15 minutes. The time taken here is 15 minutes. Okay, now here what is the number of half-lives here? Here we have to find the half-life of the reaction first of all. Once we know the half-life, we can find the rate constant. After getting the rate constant, we can find the rate of appearance or disappearance. Okay. Now we know concentration of reactant at a time interval T will be equal to concentration of reactant initial into 1 by 2 to the power N, where N is the number of half-lives. where n is the number of half lives. So 2 to the power n is equal to concentration of A, that is the reactant A, that is the H2O initial concentration 0.5 molar divided by concentration of reactant after 15 minutes, that will be 0.125, which is equal to overall 4, nothing but 2 to the power 2. So bases are equal, powers must be equal, so n value equal to how much? 2. That means there are 2 half lives. So n is equal to total time by T50. What is the total time given here? What is the total time given here? The total time given here, I think this is, this will be 50 minutes. I think this will be 50 minutes. Okay. The total time will be 50 minutes. Okay. Now, I want to find the T50. T50 is equal to total time by number of half-lives. Total time will be 50 minutes and number of half-lives will be 2. So, for each half-life, so there is a 25 minutes. Here there is a small correction, here 50 minutes. Okay. After getting the T50, shall I find the K value? Yes. How? K is equal to 0.693 upon T50. Okay. That means 0.693 upon T50, nothing but the 25 minutes. So overall units will be rate constant per minute. Okay. This is the K value. Okay. Now here, what is the rate of a reaction? That is the change in concentration of a reactant or product with respect to time interval. R is equal to minus d by dt of H2O2. Okay. Is equal to plus d by dt of H2O is equal to plus d by dt of O2 concentration by stoichiometry will be 1 by 2. So 1 by 1 by 2. So you will get the 2 times of the d by dt of O2. Okay. Now here the rate of a reaction is how much? R is equal to rate of a reaction. R is equal to shell rate K times of the concentration of H2O2. Yes. What is the K value? Just now we find 0.693 upon 25. Now what is the concentration of H2O2 at where we have to find the rate? 0.05. Okay. So 0.05. Remember, this is the only rate of the reaction. Okay. But in the question, rate of formation of O2 is the question. Rate of formation of O2. Now rate of reaction and rate of formation of O2, if you see, R will be equal to minus d by dt of H2O2. I want to compare rate of reaction with respect to oxygen. So plus is equal plus 2 times of d by dt of O2. So I want to find the rate of formation of oxygen. Rate of formation of oxygen, that will be equal to 1 by 2 times of the minus d by dt of H2O2. Are you getting my point? Now here, what is the rate of formation of O2? That will be equal to half into minus d by dt of H2O2. Minus d by dt of H2O2 will be equal to nothing but R. That is nothing but 0.693 upon 25 into 0.05. So shall I write 0.693 into 10 raised to minus 3. This is nothing but 6.93 into 10 raised to minus 4 moles per liter per minute. This is the final answer. 6.93 into 10 raised to minus 4. 6.93 into 10 raised to minus 4. That will be nothing but the B option, second option. Okay. Now, question number 67. For the first order reaction, 2N2O5 gives 4NO2 plus O2. The concentration of reactant decreases exponentially with time. Yes. First option, if you see, what is the concentration of a reactant at a time interval T? AT will be equal to A0 into e to the power minus KT. That means concentration of reactant decreases exponentially with time. That means Here, the first option, that is the concentration of reactant decreases exponentially with time, is correct. Come to the second option, the half-life of a reaction decreases with increase in the temperature. What is the half-life expression? T50 will be equal to 0.693 by K. Do you know the K value increases with increasing of temperature? Yes, K increases as the temperature increases. Are you getting my point? Once the K value increases, what about the T50 should decreases? That means half-life will decreases with increasing of the temperature. That is the second option is also correct. Come to option number C. Half-life of a reactant depend upon the initial concentration of a reactant? No, this is incorrect statement. Half-life of a first order reaction, T50 will be equal to 0.693 by K. So independent on initial concentration of reactant. This is one of the important characteristics of first order kinetics. So option C will be incorrect. Now come to option D. The reaction proceeds to 99.96% completion is 8 half-lives. Now first of all, I am trying to derive the relation between the T99.6% to T50%. Now 99.6% reaction completed and 50% of reaction get completed. Now I am writing the K value, that is 2.303 by T. Directly I am using 99.6% log of A naught initially 100, A naught minus, that is 100 minus 99.6. Here the K value, that is equal to 2.303 by T50 log of initial 100 by 100 minus 50%, that is the 50% decomposes. Okay, now if you simplifying these two, because LHS is equal, so RHS must be equal. After simplification, you will get T99.6% completion of a first order reaction will be equal to 8 times of the half-life, 8 half-lives. So this is one of the important characteristics of first order kinetics. We know first order kinetics, how to calculate the time interval between the two different fraction of the reactions. Okay, now the fourth one, 99.6% completion of a reaction time taken will be how many half-lives? 8 half-lives. That means option D is also correct. So overall, option A, option B and option D, three options are correct. Are you getting my point? Now come to question number 68. It is the 2018 mains exam question. At 518 degrees Celsius temperature, the rate of decomposition of a sample of a gaseous acetaldehyde initial at a pressure of 363 tar was 1 tar per second when 5% has reacted. When 5% has reacted, then the rate of a reaction is given. Now 0.5 tar per second when 33% has reacted, then find the order of the reaction. Okay, first of all, what is the formula of a acetaldehyde? CH3CHO. When it decomposes, in generally it gives carbon monoxide and dihydrogen gas. Are you getting my point? So overall it is a gas phase reaction. Now what is the rate expression? R is equal to K times of the acetaldehyde concentration. Okay, now we have to find the order of the reaction, so that's why I am taking the exponent as a unknown, that is the x. Now with the time interval T0, okay, now how much of the reaction get completed? 5% completed. Out of the 363 tar, 5% of reaction get completed. Okay, now what is the rate of the reaction is given here? 1 tar per second. So I am taking directly R value 1, K times of the, what is the concentration of acetaldehyde, that is the partial pressure of acetaldehyde, 363. 5% reaction get completed, means how much of reactant will be left? To 95% will be left. Remember, the concentration of a reactant left will be the 363 tar of 95%, because 5% reacted, 95% will be left. So this will be the equation number 1. Okay, and one more, at the time interval, after certain time interval t, how much it will be reacted? Let's suppose when time reaches to t. Okay, are you getting my point? That means here initially the concentration 363, that means let's suppose it is not initial, it is at a time interval, let's suppose t1. Okay, now this is another time interval t2. Now what is the rate of the reaction is given 0.5 tar per second. So 0.5 tar per second, again k. Now out of the initial concentration, how much will be reacted? 33% has reacted. The left concentration of the 363 will be 363 times of the 67%, because 33% will be consumed and the remaining concentration will be 363 times of the 67%. After getting the equation 1 and 2, so 1 divided by 2, on the left hand side you will get 1 by 0.5, on the right side KK gets cancelled. You will get 363 into 95 by 100 to the power x whole divided by 363 into 67 by 100 to the power x. Are you getting my point? So 1 by 0.5 nothing but 2, which is equal to 95 divided by 67 to the power x. Yes or no? Now here 2 will be equal to 95 upon 67, 1.417. okay, now if you see the base value, actually what is the root 2 value? 1.414. so approximately the base value, I am taking the root 2 to the power x, so that means here 2 will be equal to 2 to the power x by 2. When bases are equal, powers must be equal. So x by 2 value equal to 1, then x is equal to what? 2. That means this is which order reaction? Second order reaction. Which order reaction? Second order kinetics. What is the order of the reaction here? Second order reaction. That is the option B. Okay. Now come to question number 69. An organic compound undergoes first order decomposition. Time taken for the decomposition to 1 by 8 and 1 by 10 of its initial concentration will be T1 by 8 and T1 by 10. What is the value of T1 by 8 by T1 by 10 into 10? Now first of all, what is the initial concentration? Let's suppose A0. Now it will be decomposed to how much? 1/8 of the initial, 1/8 of the initial concentration. For such purpose, the time required will be T1/8. And similarly, from the initial concentration A0 to become 1/10 of its initial concentration, that is 1/10 of A0, the time required will be 1/10. Okay. Now here directly we can apply the first order rate constant expression. First order rate constant expression. Okay. Now here T is equal to, directly we can use 2.303 by K log of initial concentration of a reactant divided by concentration of a reactant at a certain time interval T. Okay. Now here I am writing T1/8 will be equal to 2.303 by rate constant K log of A0 divided by A0 by 8. Are you getting my point? So A0 gets cancelled. So finally T1 by 8 will be equal to 2.303 divided by K log of 8. Let's suppose this is the equation 1. Now come to one more information is given. To reduce the initial concentration to 1/10 of its initial concentration time period. So I am taking here T1/10 is equal to 2.303 by K logarithm of A0 by 10. So you will get the log 10 value will be 1. So T1/10 will be equal to 2.303 by K. Okay, so you are getting equation 1 and equation 2. Okay, 1 upon 2. That means T 1 by 8 divided by T 1 by 10. So 1 by 8 value log 2.303k gets cancelled. Okay. Now here you will get the, in the numerator only log 8. In the denominator log 10 will be 1. Okay. Log 8 will be nothing but 0.3. Okay. Now the, in the question, T 1 by 8 upon T 1 by 10 into 10 times is the question. I think log 8 will be 0.9. Log 8 will be how much? Log 8 nothing but 2 log 2 cube, 3 into log 2. So log 2 value 0.3. Okay, 3 log 2. So 0.3 into 3, that is 0.9. So you will get the answer value 9. So this is an integer type question, single digit integer type question. So answer will be how much? Answer will be 9. Okay, now question number 70. 2a plus b gives c. The values of initial rate at different reactant concentrations are given in the below. Okay, then the rate law expression. Concentration of a given, b given, and initial rate. Okay, now how to find the rate expression law? Now rate expression law, r is equal to k times of the concentration of a to the power x, concentration of b to the power y. Let's suppose the order with respect to A and B are X and Y. Now what is the first information given? Initial concentration A 0.05 and B is also 0.05. The rate will be 0.045 K into concentration of A 0.05 to the power X and B will be 0.05 to the power Y. Let's suppose this is the equation number 1. And second rate will be given here 0.090 is equal to k times of the concentration of A will be 0.10 to the power x and concentration of B 0.05 to the power y, equation number 2. And one more information is given, initial rate will be 0.72, that is equal to k times of the concentration of A, that is 0.2 to the power x, and concentration of B, that is 0.1 to the power y, equation number 3. After simplification, 1 upon 2, you will get left side 1 by 2, right side 1 by 2 to the power x. So base are equal, powers must be equal. So x value, that is the order with respect to a value is 1. And next to 1 upon 3, that will be 45 upon 720 will be equal to 5 upon 20 to the power x, okay, and 5 upon 10 to the power y. After some simplification, you will get finally 1 by 2 to the power 2 will be equal to 1 by 2 to the power y. That means the y value, that is the order with respect to b value, will be 2. So overall rate expression r is equal to k times of a to the power 1 and b to the power 2. A to the power 1 and b to the power 2, that is the option number c. Okay. Now the question number 71. What is the question number 71? A plus b plus c gives product. This is the advanced question 2019. Okay. Now here four experiments given, because 3 unknown, so that's with 4 informations, 4 data given. Now when ABC value concentrations are given, find the rate of the reaction. Rate of the reaction is also given, y into 10 to the power minus 5 moles per liter per second. Find the y value. It is similar to the previous question. Now here let's suppose r is equal to k times of a to the power x into b to the power y into c to the power z, where x, y, z are the order with respect to a, b, and c. Okay. Now the first rate will be 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 is equal to k times of the, what is the experiment number 1, concentration of a 0.2 to the power x, and b will be 0.1 so to the power y, and c concentration is also 0.1 to the power z, equation number 1. Now the second experiment data given, 6 into 10 raised to minus 5 is equal to k into 0.2 to the power x, 0.2 to the power y, and 0.1 to the power z, equal to 2, equation number 2. and one more rate will be given, 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 4, that is equal to k times of 0.2 to the power x, 0.1 to the power y, and 0.2 to the power z, equation number 3. Okay, and one more last experiment is given, rate 9 into 10 raised to minus 5 is equal to k times of 0.3 to the power x, 0.1 to the power y, and 0.1 to the power z, equation number 4. Okay, now here after simplification, that is 1 divided by 2, after simplification you will get the y value 0. Okay, next to 1 upon 3, after simplification of 1 upon 3 you will get the z value 1. Okay, next after simplification, that is 1 upon 4, after simplification of 1 upon 4 which in which you will get the x value 1. So order with respect to reactant A will be 1, and order with respect to reactant B will be 0, and order with respect to reactant to C will be 1. Okay, now finally overall rate expression, R is equal k into A to the power 1, so B to the power 0, and C to the power 1. So that means R value equal to k into concentration of A multiplied by the concentration of the C. Concentration of A multiplied by the concentration of the C. Okay, now here you can put in any experiment 1, 2, 3, 4, you can find the k value. Let's suppose I am taking the experiment 1. So from equation 1, from 1, what is the 1 here? Rate value 6 into 10 raised to minus 5 equal to k times of the 0.2 to the power x value will be 1, and 0.1 to the power y value 0, and 0.1 to the power z, that is the 1. So from here the rate constant value will be 3 into 10 raised to minus 3. After getting the rate constant, we have to now find the rate of the reaction. What is the rate of the reaction? Rate of the reaction, or rate law expression, k times of concentration of A multiplied by the concentration of C. Because the concentration of B to the power 0, so any to the power 0, nothing but 1. So what is the k value here? 3 into 10 raised to minus 3. What is the concentration of A given in the data? Finally 0.15. So 0.15 to the power 1. What is the concentration of C given? Again 0.15 to the power 1. Okay, now here rate of the reaction will be 6.75 into 10 raised to minus 5. But in the question it is given y into 10 raised to minus 5. So what is the y value here? 6.75. What is the y value here? 6.75. Are you getting my point? Now the next question, that is the question number 72. That is the question number 72. For a reaction, 2A plus B gives products. When the concentration of A and B both are double, the rate of the reaction increases from 0.3 moles per liter per second to 2.4 moles per liter per second. When the concentration of A alone double, the rate will increases from 0.3 to 0.6 moles per liter per second. Then which of the following statements are correct? Okay, now here also we have to calculate the rate law expression. Now what is the rate law expression? Let's suppose R is equal to k into A to the power x, B to the power y. Okay, now what is the first information given? The rate of a reaction will be 0.3. initially I am taking the rate of a reaction 0.3, k times of the concentration of A to the power x and B to the power y. Okay, now what happens when the concentration of A, B both are double, the rate will be become 2.4. the rate of a reaction become 2.4 from 0.3. so k times of, now instead of A I am writing the 2A, instead of B I am writing the 2B. Are you getting my point? This will be the first equation and this will be the second equation. Okay, now one more information is given. When the concentration of A alone double, the rate of reaction increases from 0.3 to 0.6. when the concentration of A alone double, that means instead of A I am writing the 2A, I am keeping the concentration of B as a constant. So this will be the equation number 3. So two unknowns are there, so we can solve the two unknowns by solving these 1, 2, 3 equations. Okay, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, that is equal to 1 by 8, is equal to 1 by 2 to the power x and 1 by 2 to the power y. So 1 by 2 whole cube will be equal to 1 by 2 to the power of x plus y. So from here shall write x plus y equal to 3. Total it is a third order kinetics. And one more information, 1 upon 3, that is 1 by 2 will be equal to 1 by 2 to the power x. That means x value 1, order with respect to reactant A will be 1, and order with respect to reactant B will be 2. Okay, order with respect to A, first order, order with respect to B will be the second order. So option B, if you see, order with respect to reactant A, what is the option here? Which of the following options are correct? Order with respect to reactant B is 2. That means first option is correct. Order with respect to A will be second order. That is the incorrect. Total order will be 3. That is given 4. That is also incorrect. That means only option 1 is correct. Only option 1 is correct. Are you getting my point? Order with respect to A, first order. Order with respect to B, second order. So order with respect to B, second order is the first option. Okay. Now, come to the question number 73. Question number 73. What is the question number 73? Accompanying figure predicts the change in concentration of a species A and B for a reaction A to B as a function of time. The point out the intersection of the two curves respected. Now here the graph is given between concentration versus time. Concentration is a function of time here. Now the intersection point, this is the intersection point. Now at this point we have to predict the time interval, that is T1 by 2, T3 by 4 or T2 by 3. Okay. Now first of all, what is the given question here? A gives B. Okay. A gives B. Let's suppose initially what is the concentration of reactant alone? A0, and product will be 0. Let's suppose at a time interval T, X moles of reactant will decompose and X moles of product will be formed, because the stoichiometry will be 1:1 ratio. 1:1 ratio. Are you getting my point? Now here at this point of time interval, both the concentrations are equal. Okay. Now what I am doing, I am equating the concentration of A at a time interval T, concentration of B at a time interval T. This is the point of intersection. Point of intersection, where at point of intersection both the concentration must be equal. So that's why A0 minus X will be equal to X. That means A0 will be 2X. That means A0 by 2 equal to X. That means 50% of reactant get completed. Are you getting my point? When the 50% of reaction, 50% of reaction completed, time taken for the 50% of reaction completed is called T50% or T1/2. T1/2. That is the first option. Are you getting my point? Now here, question number 74. In this question number 74, for a first order reaction, NA gives B, whose concentration versus time curve is shown in the graph. If the half-life of the reaction is 24 minutes, then find the integer N value. Now here graph is given. Concentration on the y-axis, time period on the x-axis. Now 20 minutes time is given and 48 minutes. Here both the concentrations are here equal. Okay. Now 48 minutes and next to 72 minutes, one more time interval is also given. Okay. Now here, what I am doing here, first of all, I am writing the equation. What is the equation? NA gives B. Okay. Now initial time interval T0, A0 is the initial concentration of a reactant. The concentration of a product will be 0. At a time interval T, what I am doing, let's suppose X moles of reactant will decompose. According to stoichiometry, I am writing A0 minus of NX here will be X, because the stoichiometry N is to 1. Are you getting my point? And one more information, What is the initial concentration? A naught. Now the 50% time taken completion will be 24 minutes. After 24 minutes, A naught value become A naught by 2. And one more 24 minutes, let's suppose I am taking second half life. So the concentration of reactant decomposes to A naught by 4. Decomposes to A naught by 4. Are you getting my point? Now here, time at 48 minutes. Now in the graph is also you see, at 48 minutes, what about the concentration of both reactant products should be equal. So what is the concentration of a reactant? A naught minus Nx. What is the concentration of a product? That will be X. That will be what? X. Okay. Now here, A naught minus Nx. Now what is the X value? X value is the concentration of a... What is the X value here? Concentration of product formed. That will be A naught minus Nx is equal to X. So I am, instead of X, I am writing the A naught by 4. I am writing the A naught by 4. Are you getting my point? So you will get to A naught minus Nx will be equal to A naught by 4. From here, Nx will be equal to A naught minus A naught by 4. That is 3A naught by 4. Nx will be equal to 3A naught by 4. Are you getting my point? Now here, what is the N into, what is the X value here? What is the X value here? Now here, X value, shall I write A naught by 4? A naught by 4 will be equal to 3A naught by 4. So 3A naught, A naught by 4, A naught by 4 gets cancelled. So finally N value, you will get how much? 3. N value finally, how much you will get? 3. Okay, once again I am repeating. Now Na gives B, initially T0, so concentration of reactant A naught. Okay, now the product will be 0. At a time interval T, let's suppose for 1 mole, X mole decomposes. For N moles, N into X moles decomposes. So X moles of B will be formed. Because the stoichiometry N is to 1 ratio. Now the information given, 24 minutes half life. So first 24 minutes, if you see, A naught become A naught by 2. In the next 24 minutes, A naught by 2 becomes A naught by 4. That means at 48 minutes, the concentration of reactant will be equal to the concentration of the product. What is the concentration of the product? X, which is equal to A naught by 4. That's why I am using, instead of X, A naught by 4. Are you getting my point? So this is the option number 3. This is the